I am here for you to learn how to fast correctly so that you keep feeling better and better and better. In thinking about today's topic, I always have on my mind what is important to people to know about how to intermittent fast, why to do it, why start, and why keep going. I started intermittent fasting many years ago when I'd suddenly gained 50 pounds in menopause. And maybe you're a woman over 45, over 50, over 60, who knows that it gets harder and harder and more stubborn fat. And so when I started intermittent fasting, I was able to lose 51 pounds in 15 months in my mid-50s. So that is a miracle. And I've kept the weight off for many, many years. That's another miracle. And so as we're aging, and as we tend to be feeling worse and worse, and we don't want to, we get to the point where it's like the terrible question of, oh, is it really all downhill from here? Am I supposed to just succumb to feeling terrible and aching head to toe and getting heavier and having life be harder and having the noise in my head get louder? I don't think so. I think that I was all those years ago where you might be now, which is there an answer? Is there some way that I could feel better? Can I just feel better? In my experience coaching thousands of people, and mostly I help busy people who are exasperated and discouraged with a health issue or carrying excess weight. And I get to move people from being discouraged to feeling exhilarated, flourishing, confident. One of the natural questions is, what will I get out of this? This is a shift in my behavior. This is a shift in how I live my life, how I go about my day. And how do I know if it's going to work for me? How do I know what the benefits will be? So let's start at the starting point. I will assume that you are dealing with excess weight or chronic pain and discomfort, noise in your head about how you feel. Perhaps you've been informed by your physician that there are some health markers you urgently need to bring down or normalize, or some numbers that you really want to optimize. Intermittent fasting could be considered a trendy thing right now. So it's on people's minds as something they could try. And what I'd love for you to consider is pausing from eating and eating a little later in an eating window is the way that human beings have thrived throughout all human history. So while you may be curious about or embarking on or a practice that feels new for you, it is the most natural thing for human beings. The body is in full repair when you are fasting. It's kind of like sleeping. The body goes into repair mode when we're asleep, and especially when we're not sleep deprived, it's really important. And fasting is as important as sleep, except we didn't know it. It's okay. We didn't know. So we have the opportunity to heal the body literally head to toe. I'll go from my own head to my own toes. My hair's growing in thicker and faster and stronger than ever before. I never get headaches anymore. I know I've learned that through fasting, we create new brain cells and we're warding off Alzheimer's. My eyesight has improved. My dental cleanings are really quick and my gum health has improved. Just all the way down to the bottom of my toes. I used to have this debilitating situation called plantar fasciitis. I don't know if anybody has that out there. It really, really hurts. I had it for about 10 years. And within 3 to 4 months of intermittent fasting, I was able to just miraculously one day I realized that pain was gone and it's never come back. So walking is easier. So think about for a minute what it is that you're dealing with. The noise in your head, the constant discomfort. The noise in your head could sound like, how come I can't figure this out? How come I can't stop fixating on certain foods? How come I'm hungry all the time? How can I turn these health issues around? How come I'm in so much pain and I want the scale to go down? It just never stops. And what's possible with intermittent fasting, which is simply pausing from eating, fasting clean, which I'll tell you about later, and eating later in an eating window of your choice. Your body will be in repair during those fasting hours. And every day, eating in the eating window and fasting clean, you will be healing and these issues will be going away. Even skin issues and moles and skin tags and psoriasis. Oh, I missed on the way head to toe, the gut issues and liver and insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes and blood sugar. So whatever you're dealing with, I'd love for you to lean in with curiosity and discover how eating in an eating window could make your life better and your whole life, but also moment to moment to moment to moment life better. In my intermittent fasting conversations, there's some cornerstones to how I think a person can start and stay successful over time. And the cornerstones are the clean fast, which I said I'll talk about later. The next one is customization. I want you to know that there isn't one right way to do this. There's a right way for you to do this now based on your life, your goals, your health, whatever you have on happening in your life. And that may change over time and it may be different from other intermittent fasters. Customization, not only in terms of the fasting plan and the timing of your eating window, but the foods that you choose and the movement that you do. It's all customized for you. There isn't one list somewhere that you can finally find the book or the list or the program that's going to lay out for you exactly what you need to restore your health and your ideal weight. Starting with fasting as the foundation and then loving the discovery of how to customize for you, which leads to curiosity. Of all the aspects of mindset, I've learned and discovered for myself and coaching so many people that the quality of curiosity is the most important one. It will carry you far. So let me explain what I mean by that. If you're approaching the day with a sense of curiosity about how long will I fast today and when will my eating window be and what will I be eating and how can I feel my very best today, if you're leaning in with a spirit of curiosity as opposed to I'm afraid of messing up or how do I know if I'm doing it right or I screwed up or how, like, confusion is the opposite of curiosity. So lean in with curiosity. You can't mess this up. Enjoy the discovery. It's an experiment. As Dr. Bert Herring says, it's an experiment of one, N of one. You are the test subject and you're the scientist. And the last piece is consistency. And it's consistency that is really the great puzzle for everyone. With the ups and downs and life happening and stresses and joys and hardships and vacations and all of life, how do I keep being a person who eats in a pattern of time, who eats later in an eating window? I am here for you to learn how to fast correctly so that you keep feeling better and better and better and you keep going, because even though this is the most natural way for human beings to live and thrive and be healthy, to pause from eating and eat later in an eating window, it does take courage to kind of go against the grain of our current society, which would entice us to be eating all the time, which hasn't gotten us the health goals and weight goals that we actually need and want. Keep going. This isn't a diet. It's not a plan that you will start and stop. Most people discover that when they fast clean and eat later in an eating window that's customized for you, and you're excited about the discovery, that we feel better. So when you feel better, you are inspired to keep going. But some days, because we're human beings, some days we're not so motivated, some days we're discouraged. And if you keep it really simple and bring it back to the basics, which is fast clean and eat later in an eating window and quiet the noise and all the confusion and all other complexities, you will be able to keep going. one of the first most obvious questions is, what will I get out of this? And is it worth the effort? So hopefully I've inspired you to think about your own life, your physical self, your body, head to toe. What are things that you'd like to change so that you'd feel better? Discover for yourself how to start and what's going to keep you going and what is an important foundation to rest on. So the important foundation to rest on would be the four cornerstones of my coaching, which are the clean fast, which I'll explain later, clean fast, customization, curiosity, and consistency. And so in this series, I'm going to be talking about, if you explore some of the other episodes, about how to start, how to keep going, what is the clean fast, you know, how someone like myself over 50 can lose a considerable amount of weight and keep it off. I know that you have so many questions. I am here to share with you the answers that I've discovered in coaching so many people. So stay with me. I really want you to be successful. I would love to be your coach. My website is fastforwardwellness.com. I'll see you there.